Oh, yes. Okay, we've got the cloud out there. Had a few scattered showers this morning. Walk with the umbrella, especially out through the West End for the... For the West End. Another couple of hours. You know what?
You know, that West End in the West End.
What happened? I was talking. I can't multitask.
You had a party last night, didn't you?
No. Barb is in my ear like, put the temperature on. So I'm trying to space bar, listen to you talk all at the same time.
You can do it.
I can do it. I can multitask. Okay, let's do this. Bad hair day. That's what I'm saying for today. We are looking at a humid, very, very muggy conditions out there right now. Already feels like 30 out in Toronto and feeling like 31 in Niagara Falls. Future temperature. So we're going up to very near 30 degrees today without the humidity. With the humidity, that's going to feel like about 35 to 37. And then overnight tonight is, again, not much relief, especially if you don't have air conditioning, only down to a low of 20 degrees. And then on Wednesday, we'll be back up to 26. So Wednesday is kind of the coolest day here of the next seven. But with the humidity all week long, it's going to feel like 33 to 37. So there are those light showers that are happening, especially out through the West End right now. They will be back into the downtown core in the next hour or so. In fact, every day here, we have a chance for showers, a slight risk of thunderstorms over the next 2 days. So no car washing until Saturday, and Saturday and Sunday will start a little bit of a two-day dry stretch anyway, and then we're back into rain as of next Monday. And there are those temperatures Thursday, one of the hottest days of the week with a humidex of 37. Over to you, Steph.
Thanks so much, Natasha. We're looking at a full closure on the northbound 404 still. All lanes are currently closed from Elgin Mills to Stouffville Road, and that is all due to a serious collision. We do still have emergency crews on the scene. As Roger said, it looks like they are taking away some of those vehicles that were involved in the crash. Still no ETA on when this will fully reopen, but we are looking at some heavy delays on the northbound 404 approaching the full closure. On the southbound 404, it's quite heavy just south of Stouffville Road, where you can see on the opposite side. People are slowing to take a look. We're also looking at problems right now over on the eastbound QEW approaching Dorval. We have looks like a problem in the truck inspection lane. So we are looking at some slowdowns right now on the eastbound QEW from about Bronte. As you can see, moving very slowly towards where we have that issue. Just people slowing down to take a look. We also have some delays on the eastbound 401 moving through Mississauga Road, and a full closure from Curtis to Holt Road has caused some significant delays from approaching Curtis. So quite the busy drive already with a couple of these problems. And now downstairs to Tammy.